out of this world games from Atari, the number one video computer system with more games than any other.
Everyone's gone Atari, the number one video game.
On December 25th, 1981, at the age of 6, my two brothers and I received an Atari VCS along with three games: Asteroids, Space Invaders, and Superman. And apparently some boxing gloves. I remember being punched in the face a few times with those gloves, but mostly I remember spending a lot of time in front of the TV with my family, playing Atari. Atari Inc. was founded in 1972 in Sunnyvale, California, by Nolan Bushnell and Ted Dabney. They first met while working at Ampex, an American electronics company in San Francisco, now known as Ampex Data Systems. It was there they bonded over their appreciation of the game Go, a strategy board game originating from China more than 2,500 years ago, along with an interest in the more recent electronic games. Bushnell and Dabney partnered together to develop a concept for a standalone computer with a monitor and taking payment using an attached coin slot. The two partnered with Nutting Associates to manufacture the units, while they developed a game called Computer Space, based on the existing game, Space War. This partnership with Nutting would ultimately fail due to disappointing sales, having only sold 750 units of the 2,300 produced. Before leaving Nutting, the two started a new venture called Syzygy Game Company and began seeking out new partners, and soon found Bally Manufacturing, a pinball manufacturer. Showing interest in Bushnell and Dabney's arcade games, Bally paid them $4,000 a month for 6 months to design a new game and pinball machine. With their new investment, they hired Alan Alcorn, another previous Ampex employee. Alan worked on a game using Dabney's video circuit concepts, creating the game Pong, based on a tennis game which was included with the Magnavox Odyssey. It impressed the two so much they wanted to offer the game to Bally, but first needed to incorporate the firm. But luckily, Syzygy was already being used by another company in California, so they would need to choose something else. So they chose the word Atari. A word, when used in the game Go, refers to a game piece or group of pieces which are in imminent danger. Luckily, the name Atari was not already used in California, which allowed them to incorporate on June 27, 1972. With their freshly incorporated Atari Inc., they offered to license the game Pong to Bally and were rejected. So the pair created a test unit, installed it at a local tavern in Sunnyvale named Andy Camp's, where the game proved itself to be very successful. They quickly distributed 10 more test units to local establishments and brought in, on average, $400 per week. In fact, the game was doing so well, when the bar owners complained about the machines malfunctioning, they opened them up only to find that the coin boxes were overflowing with quarters, which shorted out the coin slot mechanism. With the great success of their test units, they once again approached Bally about licensing the game. However, once again they declined. Bushnell and Dabney offered the license to several other companies, but to no avail. The two decided that Atari would release Pong themselves. However, in 1973, Dabney left the company he co-founded due to a stressed relationship between the two, and after discovering that Bushnell had patented Dabney's video circuit concept, excluding him as an inventor. In 1976, while developing the Atari VCS, Bushnell realized it would take a massive amount of money to bring the console to market, and eventually sold the company to Warner Communications for $28 million. The Atari VCS was released on September 11, 1977. With a retail price of $199, the Atari VCS sold between 350 and 400,000 units during 1977 and 550,000 units in 1978. However, by 1979, the Atari VCS was the best-selling console of the holiday season, selling more than 1 million units.
The new video computer system by Atari. More games, more fun.
The Atari VCS was so successful in its early years that the word Atari was synonymous with video games in general. In the early 80s, you didn't tell your friends to come over to play video games. You asked them to come play Atari. Thanks for stopping by and learning a little bit about the history of Atari Incorporated. We'll follow up in the future with more videos on the later years, as well as specific moments and the technology behind the consoles, specifically for now, the Atari 2600. Join along by subscribing to the channel as we begin our journey to learn how the Atari 2600 works, how to program it, and how to ultimately create a game. Did you have a 2600? And what game did you remember playing over and over again? Comment below. I'd really be interested to know.
Hey!
Yes?
You look like a real jerk.
Well, I am a corporate executive.